I wonder if that worked. I'll find out eventually. Well, I guess I could go to my files right now and see if it popped up. Oh, I think it did split. Okay, that's good. On to the next world. I did save before doing it, right? Yeah. Agrabah or Traverse Town. I wonder what the walls of Traverse Town would even be. Agrabah is. Who doesn't like Genie anyways? If Genie's even in this, there wasn't even a story in the last world. Alright, so we're, who is this? Ha, like it. Come on. Okay then. Get a load of this. Ha. Ha. Take this. Ha. 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 I do more damage to enemies from behind? Interesting. It might prove very useful in areas like this when I stun them. I don't think of many other opportunities I get from hitting something like the attack, meaning the back. Whoops, didn't activate it. Like, everyone likes to face me, so... Trying to have a, trying to have a situation where it's viable to have things in the back is... a little rare to come. Luckily, these guys have those big fire dudes. Like this guy right here. Him in extra damage to his back would be very nice.
Take this. Darkness.
Now that you get in situations like this where I don't stun them at all, and now everyone's just facing me. Got him. And then I could just use the Melissophant card as well. Which I think increases damage by the same amount. Take this. This one guy. Yeah, here I would just want to use Melissophant. It just increases damage, period. No gimmicks to it. What did this map look like? I think I'm gonna just go it's either gonna make me zigzag or it's gonna let me go straight across, which I'm gonna wanna go straight across. Just so I can dump the stuff into the door. So I can get rid of some cards. One or higher. How do these guys benefit Riku? Because they were like, with Sora, they were very, that's the word I'm looking for. Sora, you can build your deck with spells. You can't really do that here. Take this! Like it! And he just made himself invincible. Okay. A 9 as their first card, that's just mean. I didn't even count how much XP that gave me, so I have no idea if that was worth it or not. And it looks like... Oh no, I can go straight across. Take this. Take this. So this guy gives me 5. This guy gives me... Alright, so that fight is a total of 10 XP. What is the point of the black fungi? Yeah, I have no reason to fight the black guy, those guys. Like it. Yeah. Ha. Take this. I'll have to refresh this room later. 2 or higher. Well, what do you know? A bombless darkness. I didn't even see that. Like it. Take this. Darkness. To the ground. Take this. Like it. There we go. This room's going to take a bit to get through, isn't it? More XP for me, though.
Take this. Yeah. Ha. Your Majesty, come on! Like it? Ha. Take this.
That move is such a hit or miss, and it misses so much more than it hits. Okay. Any blue card, really? I'll get rid of that. Alright, now to... Gather the rest of them. Get out from under the ground.
Take this. Darkness.
If I hid under the map, I killed everyone else. At least one more of these will give me a level up. Level up. Level 25. Quarter way there. Not even fighting back. They're just being annoying. They're just hiding.
Like
There we go. I cut directly through the middle to get there. How did I miss this guy?
Take this. Like it.
How many of these people can they hide? Do you see any eyes in the darkness? Is it blinking? Doesn't look like it. I think I cleared the room out. Alright, what am I looking at here? A three. I'll do a roulette room. I don't know why I would need a roulette room for. It would only be for me being able to select more rooms, but... Actually, this room's kind of big.
Take this. Like it. Take this. Just me.
Oh no, please give me an 8. Ah, great. Ow.
Darkness.
I'm gonna grab as many teeming darknesses as I can.
Like it.
By far the best amount of XP per room. Especially in the later tiers. Fusion barrel. Nothing's more confusing than being smacked on the top of the head with a box.
Take this.
Very confusing time.
Like it. Take this. Darkness!
All right, next floor down. Money. All right, get up, big guy. Completely missed him. Still stunned him though. Mission success. I don't think I can actually break this. Can I jump on it? What's the point of this obstacle? Huh. So that was an odd one. Nice. Actually shocked me to go through a fake barrel. Saw some XP disappear from my eyes. Ah, great. And they're already half dead. Too easy. I had not enough cards. I didn't have enough cards. Let's go. I'm not gonna serious air combos I can get by chaining a two sides together. Which one do I want? I guess I want this one first. Four or higher. I'll do Feeble Darkness. See what this even looks like. These guys can heal. Awfully annoying. Kill them all. Only the main character should be able to heal in games. Another team in darkness, let's go. This is what you were made for.
Ha!
Very close to next upgrade. Or next level up. Is this the only door? This must be a champion, whatchamacallit, rest. Boom. So SG and Hokkaido, assuming that you two are the ones in my chat right now, Deep Rock, is there a story behind it, or is it just horde mode?
Like it. Take this. Darkness.
And I don't mean story as in like the lore of the items or stuff like that. I mean, like, do you have a quest line, a certain objectives you need to do? Does the game have an end?
Like it.
Just mission after mission. So it's like if you went to the Strikes playlist to make a Destiny equivalent.
Take this.
Or if you went to the Gambit playlist.
Like it. Take this. Like it. Take this.
I'm surprised neither of those barrels are fake. There's so many of these places where I think this barrel should 100% be fake, but it's not. And it's a pleasant surprise. I'm gonna go for a team in here. Actually, I really shouldn't. I should save those. Do I have any of the... I'll do this one. That seems like a good card to use. This is by far the weirdest layout I've seen. That was a very clean sweep. And then this goes down into, and then I could redo the black. Yeah. Yeah, this is a good rotation here. Nice. Nice. I'll duel. I could take an AoE right now.
Out of my way.
Nice. That first hit in this room is so important. And not landing on the head of the Heartless. It's getting high enough where I keep getting fireball instead of this move. Just a shame because that move's so much better than fireball. Yeah, I completely missed. Okay. Note to self, I suck. Anything over here? No one over here? Alright. Six or higher, that's a tall order. Guess I can do the friend room. Always having a heal at start a match with Mickey. I was about to say, isn't this just the same room, but this is a bit shorter, or a bit steeper.
Take this. Like it. Yeah.
Riku, you need to work on your aim.
Like it!
I would say that, I would say that there's more hope, there's more story in this area since Riku is involved with him stealing Jasmine. But he was more involved in the whale story, and we got no story to that. I also wonder if he ever gets more friends than just Mickey. I don't think he does. And I don't think Mickey's moveset ever changes either. I keep destroying things as if I'm expecting a card or money to pop out of them. But Riku can't buy stuff. And he doesn't can't change his card.
Take this.
All right, what do I need for this? I think I got everything. It was a very linear path. What do I want for this room? Seven rides. I guess I'll do Marshall walking. Is it a maze? Oh, no, I just started at a very weird angle. Oh, this is just where all my numbers are higher. I'm gonna win every single fight really easily. Stupid enemy type. You know what? 9, 9, and 9. Oh, it's this move. That could actually be really good. Are you kidding me? On his head.
Like it. Take this. Darkness.
Oh, that's a very quick darkness. Again. second first, same as the first.
Take this. Like it. Take this.
Not gonna accidentally run into him.
Take this. Like it.
Smack. Like, just ingrained in my psyche that if I see something I can smack, I must smack it. It has to be destroyed.
Take this. Your Majesty, come on.
There we go. I paid the fee for this, so let me just go in. Oh, it's just a Jafar fight, just right in. Alright, get over here, you stupid bird. Honestly, I should just break all of his cards. Like, just get darkness mode before anything else. Either the next one or the one after is gonna do it. I don't actually. Ow! I don't actually know.
Darkness!
Okay, it's the next one. Keep moving makes this more difficult than it needs to be.
Your Majesty, come on!
Oh, I'm still in dark mode. Yeah, I could just toss a fireball at him. Now, he had the unbreakable cards. But that was on the Sora campaign, so I don't know if it transferred over. and see. Yeah, he just gets the pointy attacks are just immune. Which doesn't really help pre-darkness because I want to be able to break cards. But post-darkness, that's actually rather helpful. Equal to zero. I'll do once again a sleepy dark. Just clear out this room for some victory XP of 70. Actually, 70 XP isn't that bad. That was very successful. Now I go. Do I get a cutscene up here? There wasn't a battle.
What's happening to Sora?
What's his name?
Naminé's powers are being used to shuffle his memories as we speak. Marluxia may well succeed in getting his puppet. Sora would be a valuable asset to the organization. But Marluxia and Larxene's actions, they leave me quite uneasy.
And then there is Axel. Who knows what that one is thinking?
Of course, Axel's
Vexen
a problem.
Should take care of this. His replica is soon to be completed.
But Vexen despises Marluxia. Think of the mess it would make.
So we must tell him. Isn't it better that Vexen clean up the mess than leave it to us?
Who doesn't like a good amount of infighting? That always works out for that. Alright, let me see if the other file is saved. Okay, let me try. Even if this doesn't work, I can always just download the VOD. Put the video.